And that's how I got kicked out of Canada. Hello, stream.
Oh no, you got kicked out of Canada. What's he gonna do, chat? Now he's just gonna be the nowhere cat instead of the Canada cat.
I wasn't nice enough, and I said, we'll let you back in tomorrow. But that's it. So all I can do now is say all my mean things.
You go to Timmy's and order a black coffee?
Black coffee?
You didn't order your double-double? Oh my god, GC!
My fripple-fripple?
Actually, since I'm here...
You're 9x9?
8x8?
Hey, chat.
Hello, Ashley. Hello, chat.
The Nowhere Cat, does he belong to the Nowhere King? I don't know, did you say, do you belong to the Nowhere King?
I belong to the Nobodies.
So, Xehanort.
Yes. As you can probably guess by now, Miller, I'm not gonna have Xehanort.
Cuts a mean wake.
What's a mean wake?
It's where you gather to celebrate somebody's life, but then all you do is make fun of them.
So mean. Hey, Blue Link.
Got the sea ukulele. It plays songs in C.
Sea songs by sea songs by the seashore.
One of these games, you'll be able to chain fetch quest your way to the Triforce itself.
I'm actually kind of surprised that I haven't seen a online flash game do something like that.
They almost did that in Wind Waker. You basically just kind of oops into a piece of the Triforce by just dredging it out of the ocean. Time for Oracle of Ages and its hero and main character, Ricky the Kangaroo. Finger says, or you play the Wind Waker randomizer and you have dear old grandma send you explosives via the mail.
Possibly.
Her mind might be going. Unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
go down. Yeah. I can't even use them when I'm not on land. Can't use anything on the raft. They don't let you have any fun.
No fun at all.
Also, yeah, there's all these games where we travel to the past, Ocarina of Time, Oracle of the Ages, Link to the Past, even Skyward Sword did it.
Link to the Past,
when
you don't
do
go
we
into
get
the
to
past.
Travel to a cool sci-fi future?
You don't go into the past and Link to the Past.
Nope.
And that's Breath
name.
Of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom are the sci-fi games, like... You get giant mechs. And then, you know, autonomous robots that last for thousands of years.
Yeah, despite its name, you don't go back to the past in...
Link to the Past.
That's what I can talk to you.
But yeah, no, Legend of Zelda is a time travel series. Like, that is one of the things about it. One of its main core tenets.
A bonfire.
Yeah, Majora's Mask, you travel 3 days into the past, or Ocarina of Time, you travel 7 years in the future.
Yep.
Howard Sword, you have the desert level where you have the lull. Crystals that you trigger and throw around that take you between past and present in a localized area. And then, of course, you have the Door of Time where you have puzzles around that, where you're traveling between the past and future. It's kind of interesting we haven't had anything in Breath of the Wild or Tears of the Kingdom that necessarily is time travel. Unless you consider the Shrine of Resurrection like a form of time travel, of Link traveling 100 years into the future. I don't know, does cryogenic stasis longer than a human lifetime count as time travel?
That depends on if you count just standing around breathing as time travel.
Well, that's what I specifically mean, is traveling further than a human lifetime.
Okay.
Zelda did plenty of time travel in Tears of the Kingdom. Yeah, okay, Zelda time traveled once.
I mean, if we're gonna count going more than a human lifetime into the future, she time traveled twice.
Okay, yeah, yes. Fair.
That's fair. She did travel twice.
Traveled once the easy way and once the hard way. Zelda is a very old lady. She said when she woke up at the end of Tears of the Kingdom that she was just like, it was like it was in a dream for so long. It'd be interesting to see, you know, if they do DLC, if she remembers anything. Or even just like, if she's has more control over her Triforce powers now.
If I remember correctly, they said that the dragon doll was pure instinct, and therefore she probably didn't remember.
Yeah, she probably wasn't conscious.
I don't think they're
going to
continue
have...
the story past the ending if they do DLC. Because part of the problem is that if you get rid of the light dragon, you cannot harvest a light dragon anymore in the DLC.
Yeah, that's fair. And they also didn't do that in Breath of the Wild. It was more of an adjacent adventure. Hmm. Oh well. As long as we get cast. Cass has to show up. There's too many characters in the game who are like, where did Cass go? To make it not be a thing that he appears at some point.
Miller, I'm sorry, but maybe Cass is never coming back.
Cass is dead!
I mean, if we got confirmation of that, then yeah. Okay. This is just as long as they do something with him.
I hear you, though.
Instead of dropping him off a proverbial cliff and then never talking about what happened. I would much rather they dropped him off of a literal cliff and then talked about that.
Then it turns out Cass is at the end of time. Chrono Trigger stuff.
I didn't even put the red ring on because I don't need it with the noble sword for all these enemies.
He's just at the end of time playing his musical instruments.
Cass died 12 years ago. You need to let go, Miller. What? No! Cass has been right here with me every day!
And then Miller is like sucking on his thumb with a cash plushie.
I'm not crazy, you're crazy!
He's never gonna let go, folks.
Ah, Pegasus seeds.
It's like, you need to accept the truth. Our cast abandoned, we went out to get milk. Oh. Ah, the old my dad went to get milk story. Wait, is this implying that Cass is Miller's dad?
I mean, Cass is the father of at least... what was it, 6 girls?
This looks like Mario, one of Mario's castles.
I need the Pegasus seeds to do that. Okay. Ow.
know, I know Capcom made this for Nintendo, but I can't help but feel like they incorporated so much more Mario mechanics in this game along with it. And I'm thinking to myself, will Nintendo ever ask Capcom to make a Mario game? Doubtful.
Can you
hold
this for me again?
Oh, one second.
Hey, it's Green Ganondorf again.
Yep. Never play Hot Potato. Oh, come on, that didn't count. Why do you need to talk to me? What could this mean? You told me 3 times. It's really obvious what it means. Obviously, somebody who looks exactly like me in the past did the thing.
Obviously.
Good job. him.
Rick, are you gonna get Talos Principle 2 when it comes out?
Yes.
I'm quite looking forward to it.
I already pre-bought it. Everybody's gonna suffer me watching it. Not playing it.
Oh, come on. Talos Principle isn't that much of a walking simulator. You do more than watch it.
Oh, I don't know how I can do this. Well, I might as well go up. There's nothing in here.
Yeah.
You just stand there while it explodes. Because they're Gorons.
Wait, how old canonically is Link and how many times has he died? I mean, that's hard to answer because Link isn't one person. He's quite literally a reincarnating soul or something. I think in Ocarina of Time he was 7 and 16. That's the only one I could think of where his age was specific. Most of the other games, he's usually in that sort of Builds the Roman age. Somewhere between 14 and 18. I think actually Breath of the Wild, Tears of the Kingdom might have been one of the older ones we've gotten, because I think Breath of the Wild, he was like 22, and then Tears of the Kingdom, he was like 24, 25.
Julie, if we're counting the time he spent in hibernation,
Breath of the Wild, he was 17? No. I think he was older than that.
I know he's at least 21 in Skyward Sword.
Okay, I think he was 18 in Breath of the Wild. Well, the reason that people will say, oh, he's 17, is because he went up to Mount Lanayru with Zelda, which she went up to Lanayru on her 17th birthday, because you can't go up the only people who can go up the Mountain of Wisdom are people who are wise, so you have to be at least 17 years old. Link didn't necessarily go there on his birthday, so he's probably a little older than Zelda, so I'm guessing he was 18. And then you've got 100 years in stasis. And then Tears of the Kingdom was like two and a half years after Breath of the Wild. He was 17, Hyrule Historia says. You know, I have the Hyrule Historia and I still never opened it. I got it in like 2021 and I still have not even pulled the plastic off of it.
Oh, really?
Link's designer said he's specifically androgynous to make him, make it so more people can project on him. Yes, I've heard that. I mean, come on, he's a effeminate looking guy with a skirt and long hair. Like, yes, he's meant to be androgynous.
The boss door is just right here. It's right in the open.
Just right in the open.
I don't know, yeah, it would have been more than 2 years between Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom. Because you have Hudson and Ronson just meet in Breath of the Wild, and then in Tears of the Kingdom, they're sending their daughter away, and she's already, like, talking age, so she's at least 5 or 6.
I just want to go this other way.
Man, they sure anyway, put a lot of Link of the Past references in this dungeon.
Anyway, the point is, I think Tears of the Kingdom is our oldest Link. Well, okay, again, it's like, well, do you count the ancient hero from Twilight Princess who teaches you all the sword techniques? Because that is a Link that has lived a full life, died, and then been zombified. He became a Stalfos. Yeah, it's the same difference. That's the only Link we've ever seen who's grown to no longer be young.
The dungeon music is kind of boring here.
Yeah, it sounds like the dungeon music you'd find in, like, an Amiga tie-in game. I don't know why that's what I immediately go to, but... Or a ZD Spectrum, just some kind of early computer. Like, oh, this is the Nightmare on Elm Street official video game, and it's just garbage.
You know, it actually has some pretty cool music back in it, but I get what you're saying, though, Rick. Why don't you... trying to figure what game comes to mind when I think this kind of music. Ah, Final Fantasy Tower music, that's right. That, in the Final Fantasy Legends series, sort of like this. Pretty darn challenge is the best way to put it. It's pretty darn gorgeous. Nonchalant.
Just going around in a circle here.
There's gotta be a way to light the floor. Can you light that gem on fire next to you?
No. This is one of the swap gems. Maybe use a swap hook on it. I don't know why it's there.
Just now?
Huh?
Okay, no, I guess not.
Bloop. Bring.
Ba-ding. I just like this character from Discord.
Ba-ding, ba-ding. Gloop.
Galoopa Vision.
I remember this guy. Oh. It works differently.
That's the exact same design as the Cannaboss from Link to the Past 2. Wow.
Link's Awakening.
Was it Link's Awakening too? I'm pretty sure it was in Link the Past.
I don't think this changes the battle very much, just having the ball occasionally disappear.
He just wants to... He just wants to pick up the cannonball or something. There you go.
Miller is was dead. No, I'm not dead. Just... I don't have much to play off of here. I don't know. What do you want me to do?
Oh, apparently I did lose internet. Huh. Thought. I lost Twitch too.
But...
But she went dead!
Right,
we got better.
Trixie, but you won't be able to do anything about it here.
Stay on the button. Or you do that.
Standing on the button doesn't help.
No, so what it looks like is...
Mr. Hulk on the...
I can't. Yeah. It just breaks if I do that.
Yeah.
Oh, it does.
Are you able... No, you're not able to get up on that plateau, because if you could, then you would solve it anyway. I don't think this is the path forward. I think that button might be the way back. Once you get to that area.
Then why did we beat this boss then, I wonder?
Yeah. You beat the mini-boss.
I think we're missing something.
I don't even have the map yet. Why haven't I found the map?
Good question.
BDB.
Yes, BDB. Yes, Chad. The rumors of my death were greatly exaggerated.
I do not understand these hitboxes.
Oh, they're the same ones for, where they... Say it again. I went to the past.
Link's Awakening.
Say it again.
Let me go down those stairs.
It's like we can almost hear him. Get me out of the jar! I'm inside the jar! Break me out of this jar!
How'd you get in the jar?
Somebody put me in the jar! Get me out of the jar!
Where did you put in the jar?
Why would I do a thing like that?
Indeed.
It wasn't Rick, it was Stoker. Stoker put me in the jar.
I'm more inclined to believe Joan is good. Coke is totally innocent.
Do you think it was Jonas wearing a Stoker skin? He's trying to confuse me. I don't care. Get me out.
It was three Jonases in a cape.
That is surprisingly believable.
Three Jonases in a cape. The cape had a collar that was like 12 inches tall. You could clearly understand why I thought it was Stoker in that case.
This is the most confusing dungeon so far. You just want me to constantly use Pegasus seeds to get around because... No, don't shoot them.
Okay.
I don't understand why this red wall is here if you can just easily bypass it.
Uh-huh.
There's the dungeon map.
It's a map.
How could you bop her fans?
How could you, Federic? Chat loves you. They adore you. Why would you betray them like this?
Traitors. All of them. Probably better.
Need another key. I don't have a compass.
Is this one of these dungeons that's gonna be very heavy on the bomb doors?
There's a north exit up that way. I don't think I can get up there, though.
No, you need, like, the feather to jump, like, two blocks or something.
Thank you.
back to this room.
Yeah.
Is that gonna work?
No. Seems so obvious, though. Maybe we are missing something in this dungeon.
Very clearly missing something. Bet there's like a set of stairs I haven't gone down yet, but because there's too many stairs.
If only we had another hopple feather, Ashley, yes.
Down these stairs. I just led to these two rooms. I just connected up again. Why is this even here? Why does this exist? Oh yeah, it goes to this room, which I can't do anything in. Unless I do a bunch of trial and error.
Sad following noises.
Ah. Come on. There, key. Finally.
Haha!
And now.
And I just fall down the pit so I can go back.
Now to figure out what to do with the key.
I remember a locked door. Thank you.
That day you spitball. There you go.
Cana Samaria.
I had a feeling that's what it was going to be.
Two block.
And you can cheese out of the puzzles. Also, another cool thing is this game has no magic. So you can do it indefinitely.
It doesn't shoot fireballs, though.
Ah. That is indeed a sad missing feature. Even though, to be honest, I don't think anybody really cared about that part of it.
It was useful sometimes. If you had the Cane of Samaria out and you were fighting enemies.
Fly, my pretty, fly! Gosh.
Oh, it ran out.
It just runs out at that moment, too. Now I'm curious how they're gonna. How's this gonna play a part in the boss fight? It's gotta play a trick somehow.
No, it doesn't. This is a Capcom game. They don't have to do anything with puzzle bosses.
Basically, I lift this block up and oh no, I die. Capcom has to give you a theme for the boss.
Oh.
Are you breaking the game, Rick?
I'm pretty sure they mean for you to do that.
Possibly.
Oh no, I need another key. Maybe. Yeah. When I switch it to red, I'm gonna need the key. Music is getting really annoying.
Then beat it, Rick. Beat the dungeon. Sooner. Getting you, Doom Miller. Let's put that right up.
Sure, we'll might even back. Be able to say humps. Humstiv.
I'm not going to attempt to call this a nice dungeon, just because it's so blue. We haven't seen really any ice fiends, though.
down. Go back and just put blue down. Ow.
Ow.
Another Smoky.
Huh? Just one more step to progress. Yeah?
Everything in this dungeon is just so far away from everything else.
Shoot from the bottom.
I didn't even go in the correct direction. Man, I could just jump onto it, can't I? Yeah. Like that. Okay.
There you go. Okay, then now I confess. That is placing a dirty design then.
They show you how to do that earlier in the dungeon, that you know it's possible.
Oh, did they? I didn't see that. Oh yeah, the step deck came in, that's right. Right around that time.
Another locked
Another
door.
Another key! Oh joy. What is it called? It's the key dungeon of ice.
What did I miss?
Bottom right there, it looks like.
Well, yeah, but, like, how would you actually get there is the question. Not what rooms are dark.
I know. But doesn't look like there's a file position for it.
Drifter Claps is raiding with a party of three.
Hello, Drifter Claps.
Hello.
What has the Drifter been up to?
This says, maybe, in the next room over, this room with jumps, I should be able to access the room below somehow, even though there's absolutely nothing else in this room. So maybe not. There isn't anything else in this room. Okay, how do I get to that other room? Those stairs.
I think the leveling system in Cyberpunk is pretty cool.
Okay, you don't still have the key.
Seem to go anywhere. Oh wait, I can get past this room now because I have the Cane of Samaria.
You do.
Oh, you do have the cane, okay.
I actually forgot about this room.
Get out of here.
Oh, we gotta go
all the way back. That's stupid. I'm not doing that.
Nintendo and Capcom.
There we go.
Ah, the old reset option. Never can get tired of. Ow!
Thank you.
I was half expecting you to duel that red knight, and then suddenly the blue knight just walks right into your sword.
Bring all to him, huh?
Bring it all to him. He's a hungry boy. He wants all the blocks.
Am I supposed to get that one off the edge then?
I mean, I assume the cane might have something to do with it.
Oh, these all push at the same time. Okay.
Ew.
What are you gonna do with the boss key, Rick?
Go to the boss.
Thank you. Uh-oh, here we go. Take your soul.
Okay, so this is a Can of Samaria thing. I'm also pretty sure this.
Is that it? No, can't be.
Oh, come on. Ow.
There you go. Round three. Okay, this one's interesting. There you go. Oh, oh, you'll catch up to me eventually. Oh, there you go. Okay, that's the end of him now.
Yeah, got him.
Yeah, yeah, this is Capcom theming too. They always have a boss that's based off the dungeon.
Sacred
case?
Soil is an essence of time. That sounds like an essence of nature.
Quite the cop out.
Need a rolling roll? I was gonna throw stones. I was gonna say, did you know games were bad for you?
Sorry.
I was gonna say,
that was a regular way back. Really? This is a new way.
Mm-hmm.
I need this secret.
It's a secret! 54 random gargantuan plus.
54.
Why is my pen not writing? Come on.
This is why God invented notepad.
Miller, my notepad's not working.
You press Windows R and type note.
The run button is stuck. Impossible. Okay, that's good.
To the big Goron.
It's kind of far away from big Goron.
Says I remember people giving Skyward Sword crap for not incorporating the dungeon item into the Ghirahim fight. I've never played Skyward Sword. What was the Ghirahim? What was the item from the Ghirahim dungeon?
I don't know. I have the game. I never actually got much time to play it though. I should get in on that.
A lot of the later Zelda titles started making it so that you basically had to use a dungeon item in order to.
Yeah.
In order to fight the boss. But that wasn't always the case. Sometimes you just fought a boss. I mean, that's like only half of the bosses in Link to the Past you fight using the dungeon item.
Which I think is kind of disappointing. I feel like the boss should be the sort of penultimate, or not penultimate, but ultimate test of your abilities with that item.
I would agree with that too. It's just the only problem I would attest to that is that it feels like sort of like, let's get the same area as Capcom games, which are very notorious for doing stuff like that. You get a new item or weapon, you go fight the boss. And you take yourself. Their weakness against them.
I don't think that's Zelda copying Capcom. I think that's Capcom copying Zelda.
No, because the first Zelda.
I'm pretty sure either. Miller's right.
Back on it, like the old, you had the bow in the original, the very first dungeon.
Yes, you have the bow. So. And the other one, the one where you get the hammer, you also need to use
that one against
the boss. And the one that you get the hook shot, you need to use that against the boss.
Correct. But, let's see, in the... I'm trying to think back on it now. But on the second dungeon, you got, let me see, and Link to the Past. Was the Gauntlet. Yeah, so, couldn't use that against the boss. And, let's see.
Big Goron sword.
It's huge.
All right, Maple Leaf dash El Cash Maple Leaf. And before someone chews me out, yes, I know it's a clubs.
How dare you, Miller?
How dare I try to have fun?
When you have the big Goron
with
sword,
a video game.
You can only have one item.
I also appreciate how big the icon is for it on your item.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cute.
That is funny. I like it.
I appreciate that. It's almost diegetic. Yes.
No,
Max,
it's not true.
You activated my trap card.
It's not true. You were lied to. Ha ha ha. I have the big Goron sword all to myself.
Ha!
Big Goron sword?
Didn't you know? Link is a bomb maniac. Sing those rocks away. Doing the thing.
No, not diamond.
No, that's right.
I'm looking at a different one that starts the same way. Starts the same way.
I think you went too far back.
Oh. This one should be L. And there.
There you go. Give us the big sword. Yeah. Who needs that puny level 2 sword? Dying Noob says, a regular size sword or a chest for a big sword like that? Disappointing. You do have a point. This caused one of those linked to the past chests. How do you like my moustache?
Moustache.
Moustache. Funny thing about that, that was actually a Dragon Ball GT when nobody noticed Vegeta's mustache. And he just basically blurted out in anger, I shaved my moustache, you idiots! But people loved how he didn't know how to pronounce mustache. That was clever. Mustache.
I don't know if he didn't know how to pronounce mustache. I find it a more funny idea is that the VA just showed up to drunk. Showed up drunk that day for recording.
Well, the way I saw it back then, and I'm pretty sure some people did too, Vegeta isn't, pretty much was learning Earth culture back then, and the idea in him not pronouncing mustache correctly was just very hilarious to the fans. I'm sure somebody asked Chris.
I have
about
the Goron sword. What do I do now?
The Goron sword is used to kill Gorons, I think?
Obviously.
Obviously, it's in the name.
Hello, Zelda, who's here for some reason. Zelda's antics.
Oh, so that's Zelda and Impa, I guess?
Yeah. Can I hop up that with Ricky?
No, the best Zeldas have the animal people. Link's Awakening, Twilight Princess, the Oracles, Tears. Coincidence? I think not.
Nope, can't hop up the sideways.
I'll agree with that, because also Wind Waker's in that list. That's when you first have the Rito. You first have the Rito, and technically there is one Zora in Wind Waker who appears for 30 seconds as a ghost.
We can take Ricky in town. He doesn't have any objections to that. Can you take Ricky into the past? No.
Fine. I would say yes.
Wish.
Are we counting Zora as animal people?
Why depends. Not? Sometimes they're just monster people. It's slightly different.
I guess that's fair. I wouldn't necessarily count Lizalfos as animal people. They're not, even though they wear...
We're definitely monster people.
Caves forever.
Sea jumping?
Hoping to avoid it, but okay. Falling over there.
What's that?
Fell over.
No, I just had to move my chair. I don't know why, but the letter... This is a letter chair. I don't know why, but just making small movements on it sometimes being picked up on my mic. I could type and nothing goes wrong.
Your tune echoes.
In vain! I'm in the present right now. I need to go to the past. I don't want to do that.
Gotta get back. Back to the past. Samurai Jack! Thank you.
sure there's nothing in here?
You sure? You sure there's nothing in here?
Guess I have to go down this way.
Oh, I didn't realize they were hiring Keith David again for Spawn again for Call of Duty. Oh.
That doesn't help either. How am I supposed to... Am I supposed to get to this side? The mountain range. Go through this again. Suddenly runs out of speed. By which I mean meth.
By which you mean speed. Of the Mexican variety.
Spicy.
Yeah. Get out of here.
Like, I'm literally trying to read through the walkthrough of where you need to be going next. This shit's indecipherable.
Yeah, that empties out of there. Those tunnels down there I haven't accessed.
Oh yeah, I think I remember that heart piece. It was some complicated path time traveling back and forth in specific spots, I think.
Show this guy the bigger and the sword. Be impressed. This gets me trapped over there again. Good. Base of Rolling Ridge. Okay, so it's this cave that I haven't gone in.
Yeah, I hope you like mini games. Because the Gorons love mini games.
The old man's like, you just put down my jars. Well, he says, so what's the favorite Zelda game of those in the group who are currently present? Let's see.
Wind Waker.
I'm gonna ask that in Lana, but it's here between A Link to the Past and the second Zelda. I'd say the Link to the Past, though, to be honest with you.
It's definitely through rose-tinted glasses, but it was still, like, one of the first big RPG games I ever played, and it had an effect on me, and so I will always say it's my favorite, even if it's not as story or mechanically interesting as every other game.
The Zelda series, when it first came out, was pretty much what everybody thought, in my opinion, was the go-to way for Sword and Board adventure heroes. And then you had things like Dragon Quest and Final Fantasy RPGs, which made even more popular that kind of genre, I should say. And everybody started doing it. I should just write down a list of all those kind of games I played when I was growing up, but just like Zelda or Dragon Quest or a whole bunch of them back in the Nintendo era. Let's see. There's one that stuck in the most. Destiny of an Emperor. Basically an RPG with Liu Bei, Guan Yu, Zhang Fei. That was a good one. Had a very interesting mechanic back then. It wasn't healthy. Your health was actually your army. You couldn't recover in a conventional means. You had to go to, barracks and sleep just like it was your health. Oh, it's not here. There you go.
Now you're a Gobon too.
Now you can dance like us, brother. And if I was playing this before I played the other Zelda games, I would have literally called the Gorons like mini Hulks. Mini Hulk Hogans. Just because they had the word brother at the end of it.
Goron, but with an M. Gorom? Gomon? Gomron. Gomron, I like Gomron. Oh, tricksy, tricksy fella.
I'm not thrilled. It just replaces the ones that I lost to that old guy.
Well, if you go talk to the old guy again.
Hey, they just did this again in Tears of the Kingdom.
Yeah.
Try again later. Ready to try again? Yes. Okay.
Like, they're like, the prize you can get is this! And you're just like, what the hell is that? It's just
a blanket.
Red thing.
A blanket.
There we go.
Nice.
Congratulations, Link. Here's your blanket.
Rock brisket.
A rock blanket.
That's just money. That was gonna be a piece of heart or something.
Nope. You were here just to get the rock brisket. Oh, now it's even harder. What?
Give my money. Beat this
joint.
Oh,
but do come back later.
We have plenty of money.
I will never return to this place.
I don't blame him.
Got lava juice. This comes in a bottle.
Lava juice.
There, and I got a full Goron meal.
You don't say.
Have a teleport point on this side.
Yeah.
Do this.
No, I don't think you did.
I did it in the past.
Give me some food. Rock brisket.
How did you acquire such a thing?
You got the Goron vase.
Like, one thing that bugs me about these games right here, the game ones we're playing right now with Capcom, there is a lot of fetching to do.
Like, I'm looking at the sequence for this section right here, and it is very close to just walking back and forth between the two same points, like, three times.
Yeah.
Big Bang Game. Another game.
Big Bango.
Wanted energy drink. Big Bang order.
You're gonna have to perk me up!
You need to get him a 5 hour before he'll let you play the minigame.
Yo! Gatorade me!
Technically, I have two trading quests in this game.
Yeah, I know.
I need that.
There we go. Mini game time.
I need the quicksand ring. Why didn't they tell me? Do I survive anyway? Nope.
Wap wap.
Did you need something for this?
A quicksand ring would make that much easier.
Okay.
Or does the quicksand ring just make you ignore the conveyor belts?
Just pass me right.
Sorry, I'm just reading some news articles. We can set that big timer to zero.
Oh, another leak on War Thunder?
Yes! How'd you know? Yep, days since military secrets have been leaked in the War Thunder forum. Zero!
Man.
This time it was for the AH-640 Apache Longbow Helicopter.
They must be having their hands full over there with their fans.
Yeah, they have to keep telling the fans, please for the love of fucking God, stop! We are gonna get in so much trouble.
What's up here?
I remember I played War Thunder a couple years back. It was pretty fun. It's for a free game, even. I think it was pretty rough on your computer, though, because how your engine works, let me see.
Fox Prime says I like popping into these streams because Rick's always a different shape. Yeah, that's the avatar system.
Also, he's a shape different.
Yes. Yeah, there you go. There's another form.
What is it, Rick?
Blue. Blue.
Going pretty well, Nova.
It is significantly easier. Let's make it even easier.
Try to catch me now, Burns.
I wouldn't even be running around, I'd just stick in, like, a corner.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, running around, you're still gonna get hit.
They aim for
Try
you.
Try to stick to... Yeah. Oh, okay.
Actually, it doesn't look like Well, he might do it now, but... And he doesn't seem to aim for the middle much.
Well, I would stick, like, on this one, I would stick in the top left or bottom left corner because the conveyor belt is gonna move all the bombs away from you.
Here we go.
Nope.
It doesn't matter, they're gonna explode really quickly.
Yeah, they do. That's pretty... doom.
Look at that.
Horse shifting into rocks, lobbing bombs at you. Did Link sign a waiver to play this?
OSHA
doesn't
says,
exist in Hyrule.
Pegasus seed combined with Rock's Feather. I don't know if the Rock's Feather really gives you more move speed.
Oh god, it's the house pets guy. Oh my god.
I mean, the Rock's Feather would help if you don't have the quicksand ring.
Jesus Christ.
Well, at that point, when he's spamming all those bombs, he's just pretty much following your direction.
Oh my god, Lois, it's a house patch guy.
Yeah, what's... Okay. I was very curious before we were done tonight, what was he going to give me for a second prize if he did it again? Probably rubies, though.
I mean, I can check.
Yeah, it's probably rubies. Yeah.
Well, that's a big rupee.
That is a big rupee.
Yes, it's Rick House Pets, the guy.
Me, Rick House Pets.
You're no longer Rick House Pets, you're now Rick Anadroids.
Not to be confused with God of House Pets.
Then hopefully in a few short months you'll be Rick Final Days.
Oh, here we go.
Rick Final Days of the White Flower 2. Not Rick Final Days as in like Rick is gonna die soon. I'm not saying that, Chad.
You bloodthirsty animals.
Mermaid Cave. But that we'll have to wait for next time.
Okay.
Three more to go.
Excellent, excellent. Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight and watching.
Zelda Shenanigans.
We could raid Slush again, or we could raid Duper.
Let us raid. Raid Duper.
Okay.
Let us raid Duper.
Super Duper.
The super duper low poly llama.
Yeah.
All right. Good night, everyone.
Have a good night, everybody. See you next time.
Have a good one.